everyone. Today is August 29th, 2022. We are here at Young Street and College Street. And there's a lot of construction here. And they've closed the roads down from Young Street all the way to Bay Street. I'm going to begin my walk here and make my way down to towards Dundas Square. It is almost 5:30 p.m. and 27 degrees Celsius. Today is a Monday, and I hope everyone has had a refreshing weekend, and I hope that everyone's having a great start to their week. And I'm walking south on Young Street. It is a very nice day here today in Toronto. It is warm with the occasional cool breeze. It's a great day to go out for a walk, though it is a little bit on the humid side. College Park. And here's the shops at Aura. This is also where the IKEA Urban Format store is. This is a look inside the IKEA Urban Format store. Very cool. I really like it, what they did here. And we're now passing Girard Street. Let's look west on Girard Street. Looks like there's a lot of traffic coming towards the east. Let's look east on Girard Street. Quite a bit of traffic. Here's Fire and Flower. Here's the Chelsea Hotel. It used to be called the Delta Chelsea Hotel. Hello. And here's the McDonald's that has been here for many, many years now. Looks like they got a new McCrispy sandwich. Here's Elm Street. Look west down Elm Street. There's a Scotia Bank planned to open here at the corner. This used to be a pizza store, which closed down. I'm actually very surprised that they closed down, given that they're so close to a super busy, arguably the most busiest intersection in the city of Toronto. And they had really good prices. Pizza tends to be priced very well. Very busy day out today. There's the World Food Market across the street. And there's Tokyo Smoke and Five Guys Burgers. I can already hear the very fast and loud drum playing. That sounds like it's coming from Dundas Square. And here's the atrium on the bay. They've got shops, restaurants, and access to the Dundas subway station. This bus stop is decorated with plants for a particular marketing promotion. Where are you going? There's someone selling stuff there in the form of accessories and knickknacks or jewelry. There's a person selling comic books. And there's a drummer at Yonge and Dundas, across the street from Dundas Square. Thank you. unlock my camera, and that'll give me a better view up here at the LCD screens, or LED screens, I should say. Here's the stage at Dundas Square. And there's a lot of pigeons here. Someone threw some bread for them and they said they're having dinner. Here's a look at the Dundas Square. I say the Eaton Center LED screen. Here's some other LED screens around the area. We're now walking north on Yonge Street. Originally we walked south from Yonge and College to Yonge and Dundas. And we were walking on the west side of Yonge Street. Now we're walking on the east side of Yonge Street.
Thank you.
There's a Hot Flex juice bar and the Prince Court. How's it going?
Good, man.
Good, thanks, man. Everyone's very nice and friendly here today. And here's the Sheldon and Tracy Levy Student Learning Center. This used to be called Ryerson. There's the Ryerson Student Orientation. I think it's orientation week for Ryerson students and university students. And so that's a chance for students to come by and visit their campuses and learn more about different aspects of their campuses, maybe some student groups, different parts, different aspects of their programs. They get to meet potential classmates. They get to participate in certain activities sometimes. So orientation is a pretty good time for new students to get more oriented to their future university campus. So they're doing some construction work here as well. There's a condo going up this way towards the east of us, or towards the east of this pathway that I'm walking at the moment. Here's a look at the entrance of the IKEA store, the Urban Format store at Shops at Aura. There's the 97C bus, and I have no idea which bus that is or where it's going, but it seems to be going north on Yonge Street. We're gonna get a closer view of their sign in a short bit. This one is 97C to Steeles. So this follows Yonge all the way to Steeles. And before Steeles, there is Finch Subway Station. So I'm guessing this bus might make a stop at Finch Subway Station. Here's the Baroness Bubble Tea. And of course, Global Gifts. They've been here for a very, very long time as well. This here used to be Toothworks, which was a dentist office. It looks like they've closed down. This was a Model's Pizza, but it looks like they're doing a renovation inside. So I hope that they do a comeback and come back stronger and better than ever. I wish the same for all the businesses that were hit hard by the pandemic. I hope that they all make a strong recovery. Thank you. we're now back here at Young and College Street on the east side of Young, which is Carlton Street. That's the crane that we saw at the beginning of the video, and that's the construction that they're doing. It looks like they're doing some sort of repairs on the streetcar tracks. We're gonna have to wait and see how that turns out. Here's a pizza. Man, this used to be a second cup before the pandemic. I believe it is now empty space. And it says for lease here. There's a for lease sign on the window. I wonder who's going to open up there. Maybe a Starbucks, who knows? And this used to be a Wendy's. It says that they've closed down this location. So they've closed relatively recently. I'm very shocked that some of these brand names closing down. That are some of the more popular brands that have been around for years, if not decades. I guess that means that no business, no matter how popular the brand and no matter how good their business model is, maybe the conclusion is that no business is. That's the word I'm looking for. It's been a very long day. The word does not seem to be popping into my head. Well, the point I'm trying to make is that no business is immune. There we go. I guess immune to economic forces, no matter how minute or impactful they may be. That's one of the challenges of business, I suppose. Trying to always maintain relevancy to one's target market. That's part of the reason why I'm always eager to learn more about what you guys want to see more of or less of in my own videos on my YouTube channel, so I can stay relevant and not become obsolete by market forces outside of my awareness. I was thinking of maybe rebranding my YouTube channel from Toronto Sightseeing Tours to something else. And we're now down here at Wellesley Street, and there's a look east on Wellesley Street. And here's a look west on Wellesley Street. This here used to be a Starbucks. That is before the pandemic. It is now closed, and there's a for lease sign here beside it. So I wonder what's going to open up there. But yeah, I was thinking about rebranding my channel and making it more of a personal brand. But I decided to hold off on that decision for a bit, see how it goes. So far, I think we're doing very well. I think it's very steady. I got stuff being posted every single day, and so my schedule is pretty steady. I think one of my challenges is that I tend to do walking videos where I also kind of explain some of the sites that I see as I'm doing the walking video and places that I come across. Some of my videos are strictly concentrated on sightseeing. That'll be videos like my CN Tower video, my CNE video, the Gardner Museum, and those kinds of videos. But I think most of my stuff is walking videos where I narrate the videos and I also explain the stuff that I come across and the stuff that I see during my walk, but also the stuff that I'm going through and new updates with me and my life and stuff like that. I'll throw that in there as well. So I was also like, well, you know, I do walking videos, but I also do sightseeing videos. And I also do like walking videos where I talk about the sites that I come across in the videos. So where I was trying to clarify for myself was, is my channel mostly a walking video channel or is it a sightseeing channel? Is most of my content focused on sightseeing or is most of my content focused on walking tours? Then you get into the definition of sightseeing, and I think I'm taking a very broad definition here because I don't think sightseeing should be so narrowly defined as strictly for, you know, the top 10, you know, sight-worthy places. I think that sightseeing does equally apply to stuff that we may come across and see that some may consider relatively mundane. That's why I like the sightseeing term so much, because I take a very broad definition of it. And Popeyes has, it says, due to a fire in the building, we are forced to rebuild, but we will be back as soon as possible. Wow, that is very sad to hear. I hope that they are able to recover and recover well. But that's why I want to keep the sightseeing. And of course Toronto, because Toronto is where I make all of my videos. And we're now here at Yonge and Charles Street. I'm gonna walk over to Yonge and Bloor Street. Maybe I'll end this one there. This video is getting a bit long. I have to keep it within certain limits. My goal is to try to keep my videos under 1 hour. So sometimes they'll go a little bit above. And here's what it looks like inside the Chick-fil-A. Pretty busy in there. So I think I'll be ending this one at Yonge and Bloor. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you like this video, and of course I was interrupted right when I was trying to make my farewell speech. Trying to go somewhere more quiet. If you like this video, please hit the like button. For more videos like this, please hit the bell notification icon. Please hit the bell icon and the, sorry. Long day, my brain is not working. Let me try again. For more videos like this, please hit the subscribe button and the bell notification icon, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.